Hi guys, it's Denma. Welcome to the Wolf's Den. And I just wanted to show you all the stuff I got today. It is a Walmart / thrift store haul / Dollar Tree haul. Most of it's thrifted, but a couple of things I got from Walmart and the Dollar Tree. So, most of it's books. If you're here for a lot of books, I'll put them over to the side here. That's why I'm off center. If you hear like a humming in the background, the fan's on and my parents are in the living room. So if you hear any other background noise, that should explain that. So yeah, we went and I met my parents for lunch, treated them out for lunch. Then we went to the thrift stores. We have a couple local ones. And then we went to Dollar Tree last. So, and we went to Walmart before we ate. I met them at Walmart and then we went to eat. Yeah. Anyway. My Stranger Things shirt, it's awesome. Target, I think it was like $11.99, $12.99. It's so comfortable, it's such comfortable material. But anyway, I am going to start with the DVDs first. Most of them I got, we have a secondhand used bookstore type of thing, and that's where I got most of my books from. I literally got $50 worth of books, okay? That's how many books I got. But a couple of these were from the hospice place in the Salvation Army. Or no, Habitat for Humanity and Salvation Army. So, this is the stack of DVDs I got. And most of them range from 50 cents to $2. The $2 ones were from the Salvation Army. Everything else was like 50 cents or a dollar. I got White Noise. This is a really good movie. And I had seen this before when I went to the used bookstore place and I hadn't gotten it, but I figured they're closing in December, which is really sad. So I figured I'd go ahead and get that. And then I got Woman in Black 2, because you know I like my horror movies. And this one was actually better than the first one with Daniel Radcliffe. Wild. This looked interesting. I've got it on my Netflix to watch list. So, I mean, I saw the DVD for 50 cents. How could you not? And then this was 50 cents. I couldn't leave it behind. I couldn't leave Anton and Chekhov behind. So I already have a copy, but now I've got a backup. This was 50 cents. Shanghai Nights, you know, Jackie Chan, Owen Wilson type of deal. I got this for my mom. Turner Classic Movies Greatest Classic Legends. It's got Cat on a Hot Tin Roof, Butterfield 8. The Sandpiper and Father of the Bride. This is the one I got for because she likes this one. So I gotta separate that out. This one I got, it's not opened. It was $2. I got it from the Little Nicky because I don't have Little Nicky here on DVD. I used to in The Wedding Singer. I don't really care about that one, but. And I got The Seeker. This is based off a book. It's really good. It has Baby Kato from The Hunger Games and Baby Peeta from The Hunger Games in it. It's a really good movie. It's not Legend of the Seeker TV series. It's not even related to that. Very good movie. And I got Stephen King's Bag of Bones. Stephen King, fair. Why not? This is a really good movie. I saw this on Netflix a while back, I think. For The Forgotten. It's a very interesting, like, thriller mind blank movie. Then I got Taxi with Jimmy Fallon and Queen Latifah, because you don't want to get Daewoo on your hands. Actually, the first car I went to get that was used was a Daewoo. I didn't know they made cars. I got this Lady Gaga Revealed, an authorized documentary. I figured, hey, why not? Then I got this for the Bling Ring and Spring Breakers. I've seen those two, and I like those two movies, and I've not seen LOL, so that'll be interesting to watch this. Okay. And then they have this for $1.50. It's volumes 1 through 3 of Ruby on Blu-ray. I don't have my Blu-ray hooked up, but I did get this. So, just in case, whenever I do get it hooked up, I can watch it. I also got the Twilight Special 3-Disc Deluxe Edition. It was missing a disc. I I think I already had this, but I figured for 50 cents, why not? The movie was in it, and there's a disco bonus feature, so I guess like the interviews. I don't know. But I have it. At least I have this. Because I know I have the whole set, but that's all the movies that I got. I got this cute little squirrel stuffed animal. Very cute. He is from the Wildlife Artists Inc. I don't know. That's a charity company or just a real, brand. But he is spring of 2011, number 1000 is on his tag. No name or anything, just a little gray squirrel because he's cute. Okay, we're gonna go with the books next because that's what I have most of. And that way I can clear the bed off because it's a mess because I've got all the books out. So, if we ever decide we can get there, I got 2 used Disney books. I know they're outdated, but you can still find some good information about Disney World in them. And this one is A Dickens of a Cat and Other Stories of Cats We Love. It's still like sealed in plastic, so. And then this is just for my own. This is very well used. Some Central Coast in New Bern. I'm from North Carolina. This is where I live. I used to live in New Bern. And it just tells you like places to go, you know, that whole travel touristy thing. And I got this David Baladacci, or how do you say his name, book, The Finisher. It looks like a fantasy and crime, I don't know. Usually he writes like crime, like political stuff, like army stuff, because my dad reads this author a lot, but I've never seen him write a fantasy book. So I figured I'd pick that up. I got this for Cody because every day he has to read a book, or every week he has to read one book and then answer questions about it. So this one I thought would be cute, Bat Loves the Night. It's just a really quick book, but it's about a little baby bat. It's just cute and she's just adorable, so. The next book I got was Hunted. I've got a few books in this series. I might even have this one, but this was in really good shape and it's hardback, so you're gonna pick that up. Cause I went to the secondhand bookstore that get ready to close in December, I was asking how much would it be for like all the adult, young adult novels, and she's like, well, we get new stuff in every day, so it changes, but closer to December, she'll be able to give me like a big bulk price, and I could just take them all. So I got what I wanted today, the ones that I really liked, so it looked interesting. This one, Dangerous Angels, they're all like paranormal romance, like Divergent or whatever. Dark Frost. I found this really cool edition of Death Note, the black edition. It's really cool. And it's like in brand new shape. It was $2. So I was really excited about that. And then at the secondhand bookstore, I also found these little cute Rosario and Vampire playing cards. Because I have my Once Upon a Time playing cards out in the TARDIS, my camper, but not in here, and now I can play. So, then I got this Sever, the Chemical Garden trilogy. I don't know which one it is in this trilogy. This is book 3, so I need to find the other 2, because this looked interesting. So, got that. And then Cinderella. I like any type of books that are like different takes on fairy tales. So I got that. From Bad to Cursed. So, a Bad Girls Don't Die novel. These are all like Scholastic books, so whoever like gave these up was like a kid. This one is Fates by Lanny Bross. Let's see. Okay, I think this is the first one in the set. There's also another one called Chaos. Destined to Fate's story. It's an online digital short. So, I think this is the first one. So, anyway. Then I got this one called The Unwanted. And all these are, like, in brand new condition. I mean, they're, like, impeccable. And this one, Immortal. Interworld, Eternal Seduction. This one, called The Dark Resurrection. It looks like it was published by an indie author, and I always like to support indie authors, even if I'm just paying 50 cents or a couple dollars. Somebody bought it brand new. Six even got his a note to Dave and Kathy, who I guess got this. Usually I don't read the backs of these because I can usually tell by the covers that I will read them. If the cover interests me, then I will probably read it. Even if it's not a paranormal romance or paranormal type book. I'm trying to put them in this crate as I go. Okay, we got Jessica's Guide to Dating on the Dark Side. Ooh. This is by Beth Fantasky. And let's see. I'm guessing this is the first book in the series because I got another one from her somewhere. Let's find it. Jessica Rules the Dark Side. So I'm guessing this is a sequel to it. Then I got Bianca D'Arc, Dragonstorm, Dragon Knights. So looks like another indie published book. Dragon Knights Book 6, Dragonstorm. So, yeah, so I'll have to go on Amazon and see if I can find and use copies of the first 5 before I start that. I always, if I get a book series and if I get like the second or third one, I have to get the first one before I can read it. Then The Awakening by Kelly Armstrong, who's like a really prominent author. This is book 2. So I have to find the other one to this. And I found Peter and the Starcatchers. Our local civic theater is putting this on later this year for Sweeney Todd. And I was thinking about going, so I figured, hey, why not read it and find out if I like it or not, so I can go. And I like the style of book because it's got these old looking pages to it, even though it's a brand new book. It gives it that old feel. And it's like a different take on Peter Pan. So it's going to be interesting. I'm going to keep that out of the storage bin because I'm actually going to read that soon. Then I got Halo, which is not based on the game. As you can see, there's an angel on it by Alexander Andronato. And it says an angel is sent on Earth on a mission, but falling in love is not part of the plan. This one, Born Wicked, had a really cool cover. So, I was excited about that. It's The Cahill Witch Chronicles, and it is book 1. So, and another indie author, Don't Die, Dragonfly. Private. So, this is the first one for this set, so I'll be excited to finish that. And Hilary Duff wrote like a fantasy young adult novel called Elixir, which looks really cool. I read a little inside page, it seemed really cool. Then these two have pretty cool covers. Here's part of the series, Sanctum and then Asylum. Or Asylum and then Sanctum. Lose Your Mind. These look really interesting. So let's see. I'm trying to see the copyright date because that would tell you. I think there's 4 books to this series. 2013. Yeah. Asylum goes first, and then Sanctum. And young adult books are so good because you can get immersed in this world wherever they're taking you, and they're quick reads, so I don't know why I got you up so high, I'm sorry. But yeah, this one is called Ghost Girl, Rest in Popularity. Look at the cover. That's really cool. It's got like the shadow thing, and then when you open it, it's got the girl, I guess the story is about. But this kind of remind me of like Monster High vibes. So pages are really pretty. It's got silver on the outside, like, you know, like Bibles and religious books do. I don't know what it's about, but it looks cool, so I got it. These two. Iron King and Iron Queen. They're part of a series. Let's see. Which one do you want? As well. So I'm going to make sure. These are from Harlequin Team. Okay, Iron King is book one. Iron Queen is... tell me. I think this one's book three because there's the Iron Daughter. Because it says the Iron Fae series, Iron King, Iron Daughter, then the Iron Queen. So I'm gonna have to get the Iron Daughter before I can read this one. So, but the covers, these covers are designed like amazingly. They're just gorgeous. And then this one is called Fade. The second book in the Wake trilogy, and then Shadows in the Silence, an Angel Fire novel. She must fight for her will, she must fight for humanity, and she must save herself. And her name's Ellie, and she's a redhead. She looks just like my freaking niece. That's scary. I'm actually gonna see them soon, so I'm gonna have to show that bit to them. You put these up and I've got a whole nother bag. Okay, this lot right here is from the Salvation Army, and when I went there, some girl had dropped off her Twilight Stephanie Meyer collection. I was able to get The Host, which I've seen but I've not read, and I got the graphic novel. Where is it? This is it? Yeah, the graphic novel, which has really crappy art, but you know, I haven't read it. They also had the, like, the movie companion, but I've already got a copy of that. And they had the short tale of short second life of Bree Tanner, you know, the young vampire they changed. Hadn't been able to read this little novella. So, and she also had these, two of these, Twilight Saga. They're little journals because, you know, how Twilight started, Stephanie Meyer had a dream and she wrote it down in a journal. So there's four journals, one for each book. And they all have the covers from the book on them. And in each one, there's different quotes and little inspiration things for you to draw or write or whatever. And they're really nice. And they're like, there's trees on the pages. And I hate to use them, but I wanted to get them. There was two of them. I guess I could have gotten both of them and then wrote in one and kept one for later. But I might not actually ever use these. I've never seen them before, so I had to get at least one of them. So, and I got two Vampire Diaries books, since, you know, it was, you were either Twilight or True Blood or the Vampire Diaries. You were like in one of those camps. You couldn't be all three of them. So I finally got volume one, I think, and this is volume three of the Vampire Diaries. I have another one that I got in another thrift store haul. I don't know which one it was, though, a while back, or book sale. And I got this Dead Until Dark, a Sookie Stackhouse novel, so this is from True Blood. So, since they're all over now, I figured it'd be cool to get that. It would be okay. And then I got The Martian, which we just got this on DVD, and I just watched it with my dad like last couple weeks ago, and he really liked it, so I got the book so we can read it and see the difference. Oh, there's a Five Nights at Freddy's card in here. Anybody want this? I don't want it. Okay, if you want this, DM me on Instagram or Twitter and help your address, and I'll send it to you, because I don't collect Five Nights at Freddy's. But anyway, there's that. I'm gonna take that card out and put it in another, this book, so that way it's got a hardback to keep it safe. Then I got this for Lazy NPC, because we always like to read the World of Warcraft novels, and I can't remember if he's got this or not, but you can never have too many World of Warcraft novels. It is Thrall, Twilight of Aspects. So I got that for him. Then I bought Sleeping Beauty Vampire Slayer. So, and this looks like an indie. Oh, Cinderella Ninja Warrior. It's also part of this series. Oh, and it's one of those decide the fate books. It says that three dramatic turning points in the story, you'll get the chance to put yourself into Lucette's shoes, who's the main girl, and decide what you'll do next. So that's pretty cool. I'll have to get the other one to this set. Then I got this Everlost Book 1 of the Skinjacker Trilogy. Looks pretty cool. And this one looked funny. Bite Me. You know, about it's a Bite Me, a love story. So, and then Red Riding Hood. Oh, this is based off the movie. Okay. Introduction by Catherine Hardwicke, who was the director. And the director for Twilight, too. So, I guess that's why this probably came in with that Twilight a lot. So, that's interesting. Okay, that's all the books. Okay, the next part I'm going to do is the clothes and knickknacks, whatever else I got from the Salvation Army or the Habitat for Humanity. And then we'll get to the Walmart Dollar Tree part. So, all the stuff from the Salvation Army was 75 cents. So, I got that for Cody. He's already got one of these, but he can never have two of these SpongeBob shirts. Then I got this shirt for myself. It's the Oriental Cat from Oriental NC, which is the town that whenever we say where we live, we say it's towards Oriental. It's about 30 minutes away. It's on the water. A lot of boat. It's like a boating community. But I thought, I need to go find that shop because it's got a cute shirt. Then I found this. Just Walmart shirt for 75 cents. It's just a relaxed fit tee, you know. Nothing too exciting. Then I got this for Lazy NPC. It's got the Boondocks characters on it. Not to be confused with the Boondock Saints. Then I got this for myself, which is from, I don't know where this is from, probably Target. It's the Guardians of the Galaxy. I don't know if you can see it. There it is. The print on it, but it's the ship. And then it's got the logo right there, so. And then this Justice League shirt, which I actually just saw at Walmart. It was on clearance, but for 75 cents, I'd rather have it slightly used. And I found this dress / nightgown thing. It's an extra large, but it should definitely fit. It was really pretty. It's kind of like a, it's really stretchy right here. So, I got this for my mom. I'm just going to nod and act like I'm listening. So she thought that was cute, so I got that for her. And then we found a little shirt for Charlie, which is the Chihuahua Pomeranian mix my parents have, and it says Tall Tale on it. So, yeah. Okay, I got another bag of clothes. These were from the Salvation Army. Chucklewind, which is a little bit further away. I just got, those were all men's shirts, and I just like the print, if you can even see it. It's been well loved and worn, and I thought it was really cool print. So that's that. This one is from Arizona. It's still raining in with the tags, and I got it for $1. It's supposed to be $12. Then, oh my gosh, I freaked out when I saw this in the Chucklewind Salvation Army. It is a Boondock Saints t-shirt. It's too small for me, I'm pretty sure. It's got their little prayer chant thing that they do, and it's got that on the back. So I figured I could tuck the arms in and make it a pillow or something. I'm gonna figure out something if it don't fit me. Because do you know how rare it is to find Boondock Saints stuff? Let me tell you. And then I got this plus size plaid shirt. I like plaid shirts. I just wear them over top of a tank top. So any color. This one's red and navy blue, even though it's kind of more pink and purple. Then I had to be tacky and I got this velvet top with leopard print, and it's got shoulder pads. It's sweet. And then I got this really nice woozy sweater. It's like a forest green, pine green. Even though it's not the color, so it's showing up gray, it just needs green. And it's really oversized for me. So Yeah, and then I got this little kitty cat tin at the Salvation Army the other day. And I don't know what I'm going to put in it, but I'm going to put something in it. So that was all the clothes. Now I'm going to go to Walmart/Dollar Tree part of the haul. Okay, so this is the Walmart/Dollar Tree part of the haul. It just passed over Easter, so all the Easter stuff was half off at the Dollar Tree. Same thing at Walmart, so I got that. And I saw these at the Dollar Tree. It's not my birthday. My birthday is in September, but I had to get these cards. I didn't even get the envelopes just because they're iCarly. I was obsessed with iCarly and Victorious, so I'm just going to put them up somewhere and have them. I got this cool tumbler. I think that's what they call them at the Dollar Tree. It's got these cool feather pattern on them. Got this cute little Easter bunny. I got another one for Charlie, the Chihuahua. But it didn't have any plush, any eyes on it. They were all like sewn fabric eyes, so if he chewed at it, it wouldn't choke him or anything. So he can easily chew to away. I got Beauty and the Beast 3. And double bubble eggs, those. And I got this magnet, and it says cat sleeve paw prints in your heart. Everything else I think is from Walmart. They had these nightgowns on clearance for $3, so I got two of them. They are just, it's just a pattern of Valentine's Day kitties, it looks like. But they're like super baggy on me. They're 2-3X, so I like baggy sleep shirts like that. And then all their Easter stuff was on half price, so I got a little. I want a new Easter accessories, the light up cat ears. Very cool. Then I got these pretty, like, what is it? Laurel type cat ears. They're shaped like cat ears in the back, which you can't really tell, but I thought they were pretty. Then I got this hair tie. It's a little bunny bunny. It's got bunny ears and little paw pads. And these little tiny little hair clips for this, like, I have one strand of hair that, like, gets in the way, so I figured I can hold it in with these cuties. So I will be using those a lot. Then I got one more bag. I'll put those back in here. I put my little Easter candies in here. It was originally for, like, cookies or something. So that is being used. And at Walmart, they had on clearance a lot of their, like, printed shirts. So I got this cool Darth Vader one, which is long sleeve, and then I got this one. It's gonna be kind of tight on me. It's 42-44, and I usually lean towards the 44 end, but I got it because of what it says. I haven't seen it at Walmart before. It says, "Nice suit, Vader. I bet that cost you an arm and a leg." Thumbs up this video if you get that reference. The mom saw this, and this is a cute kitty tank top stretchy thing. It is, I think, just a large. Oh, it's extra large. But it's in juniors. But since it's sleeveless, it should be alright. They usually have at least one 2X. But because when I worked at Walmart, they would get these in and they only send two X extra larges of these in. They were sold out of them. So then I got this cool Gatsby kind of reminded me of The Last Jedi shirt. And then one more shirt. I think this is also The Last Jedi. And it's got the whole crew up there. It's Kylo. It's got Phasma. It's got Luke, Finn, Poe, Chewbacca, Rey, Knights of Ren, but no Hux. Why does it not have Hux? He's my favorite, but I still love it. I collect t-shirts and graphic tees like normal girls collect purses and shoes. I have like two pairs of shoes and one purse that I use. So anyway, that is this haul. I hope you enjoyed it. Let me know what your favorite find that you found thrifting is. It's always fun to go out and see what people have given away and donated and seeing what you can do with it. Or if there's a book that you're looking for or you've been on the hunt for and you can find it, it's that satisfaction feeling, because I like my books used. It gives them a little character. But yeah, thumbs up, like this video, subscribe, join the pack, and come back and see another video next time. Until then, I hope you enjoy. Like I said, I really do like going thrifting. We try to go every couple of weeks because it does go towards a good cause, and that's about when they get all the new stuff out for the people that come to scalp it and put it on eBay or resell it. But yeah, hopefully I'll do some more videos like this in the future. And like I said, leave a comment down below of your favorite thrifting find that you've had, or like an amazing thrift story that you have. I would love to read it and see what you guys can come up with. Bye, guys. Mm-hmm.